Welcome to my YouTube channel Park Civil Engineers. So in this video I will discuss about hydraulic cement and its composition. So I want to discuss in detail that what is the hydraulic cement and what is the composition. Okay, so actually you should know first of all that cement is actually the binding material. Binding material means which take part in the bond formation. So there are actually two types of binding material. One is hydraulic and what is non-hydraulic binding material. Hydraulic binding material is this type of material which make of bond after the reaction with water. Okay, and non-hydraulic like cement and lime, this is the hydraulic binding material. And one is non-hydraulic binding material like bitumen. Non-hydraulic binding material means the material that have their self cohesion property that make a bond without reaction with water, that is called non-hydraulic binding material. So actually the cement is hydraulic, we call it hydraulic cement because it make a bond after the reaction with water. So this reaction is called when the water and cement are meet to each other, they do the reaction, that is the chemical reaction, and this chemical reaction is called a hydration reaction, and this hydration reaction causes a formation of bond. Okay, so first of all, when the water meet with the cement, mixed with the cement, what happen? So it takes the plastic state, but with the passage of time, so when its initial sitting time paused, so our cement start hardness. Okay, so one stage comes that our concrete become like a stone like mass. It become too much hard and it have an ability after hardening, that after hardness, that it can carry easily the design load. Okay, so Portland cement, actually the composition of the Portland cement is that it consists of many oxides. There are different oxides that are the part of the cement formation. Okay, so one is the lime, we also call calcium oxide, silica, as well as alumina and iron oxide. Okay, there are different oxides. There are the part of essential part of cement formation. So I will discuss in detail that calcium oxide, this is the oxides that are exist in cement. Okay, so I will discuss the source of all oxides, that how we obtain, from where we obtain it, and what is the function of these oxides in our cement. So I want to discuss in detail the lime, that is also called calcium oxide, from where it's obtained, what is the source of it that we obtain the lime. So actually the limestone, chalk and calcareous rock. Calcareous rocks means I have written in the bracket here, the underlined words means the calcareous rock is underlined. Okay, so it means those rocks which can contain maximum calcium carbonate elements compounds, that is called calcareous rocks. Okay, so from these different source we obtain the calcium oxide. Okay, and what is the function of this oxide in our cement? Actually if there is a specific percentage, specific limit that we use these all oxides. Okay, if the lime we use in excess amount, what is the disadvantages of it? Because that we called the free lime. Free lime means those lime that during the mixing of the material, the mixing of the material with water, it does not react some part of the lime with, it does not react with the water, so some part of the lime remain unhydrated. When our concrete become hardened, and after that when this free lime comes in contact with the water, so it reacts. After the reaction, our concrete become disturbed. it become disintegrated, and its volume also also increase because due to the reaction of water and the free lime. So due to the free lime, our concrete become disintegrated and fail. So therefore, in excess amount, we should not use this lime. This is the disadvantages. But if we use the lime in small amount, so what happens? So due to their deficiency, the strength of the cement decreases, okay, as well as the setting time of the cement increases. It means that the cement becomes set very quickly. So it is not good for the cement, because when our cement become set very quickly, so due to these the cracks happens in our concrete, okay. So after that, the another one, the most wanted oxide is the silica oxides. What is the source from where you obtain? From sand, clay. Clay means alumina, but in alumina there are some impurities of the silica that we obtain from it, and argillaceous rock. It means in the bracket it have written that 10-20% clay minerals exist in argillaceous rocks. So is the impurity, the silica also exists in these sources we obtain from these different sources. Okay, so what is the function? Function is that there are different compounds that I will discuss it later, but the main formation of the silica in the calcium disilicate and calcium trisilicate. Okay, due to formation of these different compound, it gives strength to our cement. Okay, so if the silica is present in excess quantity, the strength of the cement increases. So it is so after that, there is the third one oxide, that is called alumina, also called aluminium trioxide. Okay, from where we obtain? What is the source of this oxide? Bauxite. What is the bauxite? Bauxite is actually the rock, okay, but those rocks in which the aluminium elements is exist in excess amount. Okay, from these bauxite rock we obtain this alumina, as we recycle alumina and clay. These are different source of alumina, okay, aluminium trioxide that we get from these different sources. So what is the function? The function is that it gives the quick setting property to the cement. Okay, so by the use of alumina, it gives the quick setting time to the property to the cement. And iron oxide, from where we obtain the lost one oxides, we have obtained from clay, iron ore, scrap iron, and different others element like fly ash. Okay, from these different sources we obtained iron. And what is the function? So the color of the cement is due to the iron oxide, its hardness. It gives also hardness and also gives some strength to our cement. But the main function of this oxide is to impart the color to our cement. Okay, so after that, there is some compounds. Okay, there is some compounds, but these compounds I want to discuss in the second video, because our video become too much lengthy, and I hope that you will become bored to watch a single video too much lengthy. So therefore, the second topic is the cement compound. It is also the detailed topic I will discuss in the second video. So I hope so that this topic you will understand. If there is any difficulties in understanding, any confusion, you can comment me. Thanks for watching.